Zulu as my home language and English as first additional language. Now the APT test has already excluded me from the academic work because I am not tested on my lingual ability but my ability on English. So already we've got students who are disadvantaged in the language area, which is something that we plan to tackle on a national level. I've made ties with Roads Must Fall Committee and the Leicester Committee, which is a documentary from Stellenbosch, which I think you guys must actually watch. The SRC is a very liberal structure if you come to think of it. Here you, just as much as governance in South Africa is liberal, here you have people who are saying we're going to do things for you, but in actual fact you're the only person who can do those things, and what they can do is be at the forefront. The best way to change things is student activism. Nothing happens unless students are involved. The reason why tax has not changed and has remained the way it is because students are at the back and the SRC in the front. And that's what we want to change. We want to mobilize students and make them aware that if students come together in one voice, things actually do change, believe it or not. With the Roads Must Fall campaign, it wasn't just about the statue. It was about the curriculum that we are also fighting, which is not free. When we say free and quality education, we don't only speak in terms of monetary, we speak in terms of the academics itself, that you are limited to sources that are colonial, you know. Your sources that you write on have been written over 1960, and the agenda is capitalism and imperialism, and that is what this university is about capitalism and imperialism. An example is on your student cards. If you look behind it, there's an ABSA logo. Barclays, that's a clear indication of how the direction we are headed as students, as black students. You are headed for debt. You can't get a bursary today, but then you have to pay it off by working for that company. And that is what we are against. We are against students being sent back home because they don't have registration money. And these things can change. We've seen them change. The same with the Jackson campaign, 1,500 students were registered because of the EFF. We had them registered while they were blocked. Because of funds, because we came together and said, we will shut it down. And now if this is a collective agenda of all the students, a lot of things can be done, you know. And I say, I am putting my academics on the line to make sure that other students are given a chance to. I'm doing my master's next year. I've made alliances with Khumani Manqele, the guy from Roads Must Fall who went to a court case Izolo and was expelled. And Xebo Dlamini, who also came here to show solidarity and support for me, who's actually from SASCO.
Yes.
And we've decided to make the whole thing of student activism a national agenda. Yes, a national agenda, where we are going to devise a structure that the universities will be forced to adopt that are anti-colonial and pro-black, because right now we are striving under institutions that are anti-black, where even if you do get through the university, you will be filtered through. The first step is the APT test, like I said. The second step is financial exclusion. The third step is academic exclusion. These students are not excluded because they are not smart. No, they're excluded because they do not have the resources that the other people do have.